Hello friends, welcome to Acquire IAS. So today we are going to discuss an important topics, right friends? Important topics which is most important for UPSC, prelims, right friends? And various other kind of competitive examinations as well. You can download the newspaper analysis on daily basis from our Telegram channel. That is, you can type as Acquire IAS, right friends? Acquire IAS, you can type Acquire IAS and you can call me on this following number for personal guidance, that is 9640123412, right friends? So let me move further. Here you can join our WhatsApp number as well, and you can follow me on my Facebook page. You can subscribe this blog for getting an interesting articles related to personality development and UPSC other related articles, right? So these are our offline batches, right friends, which are going on. You can join as well friends, which is in Bodhan, Telangana, Nizamabad district friends, right? So next we see further here. Today's our agenda is ancient history's important topics for UPSC prelims, right friends? This is our today's agenda. So let me tell you friends before, so whatever the topic I have said here to you, you have to cover the entire nook and corner of the topic friends, right? You should not just read some sort of passage or some sort of subtopic and you need not to get fulfilled that yes, I have done, right friends? So if you read these 16 to 20 topics, then you can easily answer questions from the ancient history, right friends? So first of all, let me tell you here, composition of hymns of the Vedas. So Vedas, right? Now here I am saying composition of the hymns of the Vedas. So first of all, you should cover all the Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda, etc., right friends? So first of all, here you have to cover in that way. And second thing, you have to see who it was written by, whom, right friend? It was composed in which year, right? And it has been translated in other languages or not. It is patronized by whom? It is during which ruler period? Right friends? So these kind of questions you have to cover as well simultaneously, right? And these kind of glance you need to do by your personally. No book will teach you, friends, right? So next year we will see about various eras, right friends? Various eras. Next, Gupta period. Next comes to various philosophies like Buddhism philosophy, Jainism philosophy, Christian philosophy, Hinduism philosophy, right friends? So Parsis philosophy, you have to cover entire philosophy, and you need to cover famous authors among them as well, right friends? So next we see about the important terms, right friends? Terms which you need to most probably cover from the newspaper itself, that is current affairs friends, because it is most important and favorite topic of the UPSC, because each and every year the UPSC will bring you at least a single question friends, right? Next we see about the Jainism and Buddhism. So just now I said that you need to cover the nook and corner of the topics, everything, right friends? Next we see various scripts, various school of the arts. Next here, 16 janapadas means you need not to cover only 16 janapadas, but you need to cover the locations as well. Locations, who is the ruler, at what time, right friends? And what are the forts he did, right? So these things all you need to know before going to the exam, right? So various locations friend means like the locations of the 16 janapadas, locations of the Harappan civilization, the locations of the Mesopotamia, right friends? So etc. So in this way you have to remember all the locations. And in locations, next we will see, I'll tell you that later friends. Next we see about the various sports. It will come under various locations only, but I have specifically mentioned it because you may get you may forget friends, right? Next, we will see about the foreign travelers who traveled to India and what he did, what are the records he left here, and what are the statements he made in his records, right friends? So these are the foreign travelers, which is most important topic, which is important for UPSC prelims as well as mains friends, right? Next, you can see here the various dances as well, various dance, songs, arts, paints, festivals, etc., right friends? So everything you need to cover here, and various books and its authors friends, this thing I have said you from since the beginning as well. So these 15 topics you need to cover from each and every point friends, then only you can easily grab the marks from the ancient history which is asked in the UPSC prelims, and it is also simultaneously important for various other government examinations as well, right friends? So next we see here other topics which are related to ancient history, that is questions based on Ashoka, questions based on Mimamsa system of philosophy, questions on that is concept of Anuvrata, Jain literature, Chandela, Chalukya, Pallava, Mahayana Buddhism, Gandhara and Himayana schools, various schools, right friends? Concept of Eightfold Path, right? Next we see here Hun invention, Rome Empire, Greeks, Shakas, Parthians, Mughals, Nandas, Mauryas, Shunga, Kanvas, various councils, that is Buddhist councils, various Buddhist councils, various Jain councils. Next, Chola, Chera, Pandyas, right? Next we see Surya Varman II, Rashtrakuta Empire, Ikshvaku rulers, Pala rulers, Samudragupta, Baudhanya Sulva Sutra, right friends? These all questions are asked in our previous examinations friends, right? So your primary focus should be on these topics only, right friends? And these topics are repeated in many years as well friends, so you need not to go for any analysis right now because you don't have time, but if you feel you have enough time, you can go and check each and every point whatever I have mentioned here, you can see in the previous examinations in one or some other part, right friends? Next we will see what are the other type of questions the UPSC may ask you, right friends? UPSC may ask you in this format. For example, it will give you an India map in this format, and it will give you four options, right friends? 1, 2, 3, 4, and it will tell, right? So now it will say mention it, right friends? So mention it the correct form, that is from east to west direction, or as north to south direction, or as what are the locations which is mentioned in options A, B, C, D, R, and it will give in this format, that is Chola, Pandya, etc. friends, right? And it will say identify the following, and it will give options, option A something something, option B, etc. in this format, right? So you have to remember as well in this formats as well, that is map based locations. Next, it will simultaneously ask you in this format as well, that is this question has been asked in 2019 as well friends, like CODDIGI, which is a site of the Harappan civilization, and it will give three other sites as well friends, right? So it will say which of the following is part of the Harappan civilization, which of the following is the site of the Harappan civilization, which of the following is not the site of the Harappan civilization, and etc. In this format you have to remember. Next it will say list 1, list 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, it will say match the following friends, right? So you have to match here 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever the correct sequence it will be, right? So next we will see further it will ask about what it will say, like for example Let me tell you in this way, right? So it will give you year, students. 19 It will give you years like 65, 70, 75 and 80, and it will give some incidents, some events, right friends? So you have to match the following, whichever the correct, whatever the correct answer for this, right friends? So in this way you have to prepare for the UPSC prelims, friends, right? So I hope you understand this. So these are few kind of formats which is most frequently asked in the UPSC prelims, friends, and various other kind of examinations as well. So you need to follow in this way, and I will come with other medieval and modern history as well in next videos. Till then, stay tuned with the Aquarius. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Subscribe for Aquarius, friends, right? So that is it for this video, friends. Thank you very much.